Welcome to our first video in our SOLIDWORKS What's New for 2025 series. My name is Ed Hawkins, and over the next few minutes I will take you through some of the improvements at part level. Our goal with this assembly is to create a simplified representation of it, either for replacing it in a parent assembly or to send it out for quoting while protecting intellectual property. However, there are some operations that we need to do in the part environment, so we'll need to create a multi-body part from this assembly. First, in SOLIDWORKS 2025, you'll see a huge improvement in components with a large number of cosmetic threads. Opening the file, rebuilding, creating features, editing features, and more. You'll notice that this assembly is in the Y up orientation, but our supplier has asked for the Z up. Since we are converting this assembly to a multi-body part, which was introduced last year in 2024, we are prompted to select a part template. SOLIDWORKS 2025 allows you to select either Y up or Z up orientation when creating both part and assemblies. Let's quickly add a few chamfers here. SOLIDWORKS 2025 makes adding chamfers a breeze with the Selection Accelerator toolbar. Similarly to fillets, you can now select multiple edges very quickly. This part is missing a groove bead weld. SOLIDWORKS 2025 introduces a new weld type that effortlessly fills this gap. We'll discuss this more in the weldments demo. Our part is finalised and ready to be simplified. In the past we have had a single defeature method, but now we have a new option for silhouette geometry, where we can create simplified models based on the outline of the bodies. Each simplification method adjusts the overall part detail. Cylindrical, polygon outline, tight fit outline, and an option to keep internal loops such as holes. Silhouette defeature offers two output methods. To send our part to a supplier for quoting, save as a new document would be best. To replace this component in an assembly as a simplified version, creating a new configuration would be best. The next multi-body part needs some finishing touches. In SOLIDWORKS 2025, improving a part's performance is easy now that we have graphics triangles count and face count. Graphical triangle count effectively tells us how complex the part is and how difficult it is to render. Face count reports the number of faces, which also affects performance as well as file size. This part has over 26,000 triangles, which means that curved faces appear very smooth, but also means that panning, zooming and rotating could be slow and therefore reduce our productivity. We can easily reduce this impact by adjusting this slider in the document properties. Notice that we've reduced the triangle count from about 26,000 to around 9,000. Faces with tight curvature are a common culprit. This variable fillet seems pinched. No problem. SOLIDWORKS 2025 introduces the continuous edge blend option for variable size fillets. This creates smooth, continuously blended faces, which will reduce triangle and face count. Before finalising our performance evaluation, we can see that a sketch pattern has a high rebuild percentage. Sometimes moving the rollback bar below these items will require all of our computer resources, but this cut sweep may give us a hint. Someone has cut threads in the sheet metal body, which is not a best practice. Patterning these features makes the computation problem much worse. Fortunately, in SOLIDWORKS 2025, deleting features below the rollback bar is as simple as a right mouse click. This body is planned for injection moulding. To roughly quote the cost, a projection onto a plane normal to the pull direction is needed. SOLIDWORKS 2025 makes this easy. Simply select the body or faces and the projected plane to find the area. This part is almost complete now. However, moving the rollback bar reveals a sketch error. Editing the sketch, we can see that this 2mm dimension has lost its reference and is dangling. Reattaching it to a new reference is easy with this red drag handle. However, SOLIDWORKS 2025 makes this even easier with automatic repair. It can be accessed in the right mouse menu or by opening the Display Delete Relations property pane. There are options to automatically find a replacement or simply click Repair All Dangling. Very handy if you have a lot of dangling relations. SOLIDWORKS 2025 helps to boost your productivity by improving cosmetic thread performance for parts with a large number of shaded threads, gives you more flexibility, allowing you to choose Y-up or Z-up orientations, helps you quickly select multiple edges when creating chamfers, and helps you quickly create simplified representations of your part with Silhouette Defeature. SOLIDWORKS 2025 also helps you improve your part's performance by revealing graphical triangles and face count, create smooth, continuously blended variable size fillets, delete complex or broken features below the rollback bar, streamlines difficult workflows like the measurement of a projected area, and repair dangling sketch entities lightning fast. Let's briefly go over some of the enhancements that we weren't able to show in the demonstration. We can now automatically convert meshes to standard B-Rep, a superior and more compatible geometry. SOLIDWORKS now imports 3MF beam lattices as parasolid lattices, graphics mesh or wireframe. With SOLIDWORKS 2025, we can create linear or circular patterns of reference geometry, and Move Copy Body has now been enhanced to allow equations, configurations and dimension flipping. And finally, Curve Through XYZ Points now gives us the option to start at a user-defined coordinate system. We can convert entities as construction geometry as well, saving several extra button clicks. Thanks for watching, and look out for our next video on what's new for sheet metal and weldments in SOLIDWORKS 2025.